This video will cover the different ways to use comments in IDA. They are a handy way to leave notes for yourself regarding your progress as you analyze a program. As you will see, there are several types of comments that you can use in your work. We will begin with the regular comments. These are placed at the end of the disassembly line, delimited by an assembler-specific comment character, semicolon, hash, at sign, and etc. A multi-line comment shifts the following listing lines down and is printed aligned with the first line, which is why they can also be called indented comments. To add a comment, right-click on the selected line and choose Enter Comment. Alternatively, use the colon hotkey. To edit or delete a comment, repeat the action and edit or delete the content. Another option is repeatable comments. These are equivalent to regular comments with one small distinction. They are repeated in any location that refers to the original comment location. For example, adding a repeatable comment to a global variable will be printed at any place the variable is referenced. A regular comment, added at a location that is displaying a repeatable comment, overrides the repeated comment, and as a result, only the regular comment will be displayed. To add a repeatable comment, right-click on the selection and choose Enter Repeatable Comment, or use the semicolon hotkey. Moving on to the function comments. They are repeatable comments added at the first instruction of a function. Function comments are printed before the function header and at any place the function is called from. You would want to use these comments to describe what the function does, but in more detail than can be obtained from the function's name. To add a function comment, just use the semicolon hotkey. The following comment type that we will cover is anterior and posterior comments. To begin with, anterior means that the comment will be printed before the current address, while posterior will do it after. They will echo the comments as separate lines of text, shifting all other listing lines. These comments are suitable for extended explanations and other freestanding text. Contrary to regular comments, these are not prefixed by a semicolon character. To add an anterior comment, use the insert, or for Mac users, I, hotkey. For a posterior, use the shift plus insert, or for Mac users, shift plus I, hotkey. It is also possible to add pseudocode comments. These are indented comments and are stored separately from the disassembly comments. However, function comments are shared with those in disassembly. To add a comment in pseudocode, use the forward slash shortcut and block commenting by using the insert, or for Mac users, I hotkey. The automatic comments are comments added by IDA into the disassembly. There are a few examples that we will mention in this video. Auto comments. These are predefined comments for all instructions. If you forgot the meaning of a certain instruction, you can use this feature to get comments on all screen lines. Remember that IDA does not give comments to simple instructions, such as move instruction, and does not overwrite existing comments. To activate this option, go to Option, General, Disassembly tab, Display Disassembly Line Parts, and click on the Auto Comments checkbox. Demangled names could be shown as auto comments by default. If you prefer the more human-friendly demangled names, just go to Options, Demangled Names, and make sure the radio button Comments is activated. String literals. This option tells IDA to display the contents of the string literal next to the instruction or offset that refers to the string. It is enabled by default, but can be turned off in Options, General, Strings tab. We hope that you enjoyed this video. Show us how we did it below, and don't forget to keep following our channel for more helpful content.